Good morning, students. Today we will see about the newborn assessment. Physical assessment is a continuous process that begins during the interview, primarily by using inspection observation. During more formal examination, tools of percussion, palpation, auscultation added to the enhanced and refined assessment of body system. Newborn examination is a systematic examination, both physical and neurological, of a newborn. Objective is to provide an assessment of infant's state of development of well-being, to detect any deviation from the normal, to assess the progress of the child. General guidelines for physical examination of a newborn. First, we have to provide a comfortably warm and non-stimulating examination area. To prevent heat loss, undress only the body area to be examined unless the newborn is already under a heat source or is radiant warmer. Proceed in orderly sequence, usually head to toe. With the following exceptions, perform first of all procedures that require quiet observation like position, attitude and respiratory. Then proceed with quiet procedures, this auscultation of the lung, heart and abdomen. Perform disturbing procedures, just testing the reflexes last. Measure the head, chest and length at the same time to compare the result. Proceed quickly to avoid stressing the infant. Check the equipment and supplies are working properly and are accessible. Comfort the infant during and after the examination if the child is become upset. Hold the infant hands against his or her chest. Swaddle and hold. Indications for newborn assessment. First, the examination, a detailed one in labor room within 2 hours of birth. Second, examination before discharge. Third one, after 6 to 8 weeks of neonatal life. Terminologies. Small for gestation is less than 10% of weight at the time of birth. LGA, more than 90% of weight at the time of birth. Appropriate for gestational age is the birth weight between 10 to 90%. Full term is between 37 to 42 weeks or 259 to 294 days. Preterm means after 28 weeks but before 37 weeks. Postterm after 42 weeks. Articles required for a newborn assessment: a TPR tray containing hand washing articles, apron, stethoscope, inch tape, torch, bowl containing cotton weighing machine, bowl with extra cotton, Macintosh kidney tray and paper bag. Initial assessment of the newborn, first identification, check identity, the sex of the infant and verify records with the correct name, sex and registration number. Second, gestational age, full term, preterm, postterm. Vital signs, check the vital signs in the following order. First is the respiration, second is the heart rate and third one is the temperature. Physical examination, the length, crown to heel length and infant in supine upside down with the knee slightly pressed down to obtain maximum leg extension. Normality is 47 to 50 cm. Head circumference is measured, the tape measure drawn across center of the forehead, most prominent portion of the posterior head. It is 33 to 35 cm. Chest circumference is measured, the level of nipples around 2 cm less than that of head circumference. Weight is average, birth weight is 2.5 to 3.5 kg. Posture and movements, supine positions with partial flexion of the arms, legs and hand commonly turn a little to one side, hip joints are partially abducted. Movement is most evident in the face and limbs, unusual movement or lack of movements and asymmetry should be noted and reported. Skin color. Most newborns have a ruddy complexion because of the increased concentration of red blood cells in the blood vessels and decreased the amount of subcutaneous fat. This ruddiness fades slightly over the first month. Peripheral cyanosis appears due to immature peripheral circulation. This is normal phenomena in the first 24 to 48 hours after birth. Central cyanosis indicates decreased oxygenation, may be a result of temporary respiratory obstruction or underlying disease. Vernix caseosa. It is a white cream cheese-like substance that serves as a lubricant secreted by the fetal sebaceous gland, which disappears within few days. Lanugo is the fine downy hair that covers newborn shoulder, back, upper arms. It may be found also in the forehead and ears. Preterm newborns have more lanugo than the postterm. Desquamation, peeling of the skin, takes place few days after birth and most marked on the hands and feet. Melia, newborn sebaceous glands are immature, therefore pinpoint white papule can be found on the cheek across the bridge of the nose of the newborn. It disappears 2 to 4 weeks. Erythema toxicum, it begins as a papule, increasing in severity to become erythema by second day and then disappearing by third day. Forceps mark. If the forceps were used for birth, there may be a circular or linear contusions matching the rim of the blade of the forceps on the infant cheek. These marks disappear in 1 to 2 days along with the edema that accompanies it. skin target. If the fold of the skin is grasped between the thumb and fingers, it should be feel elastic. When it is released, it should be fold back to form a smooth surface. If severe dehydration is present, the skin will not smooth out again and will remain in the elevated ridge. Mongolian spot, a slate gray to blue black lesions usually over the lumbosacral area and buttocks. Accumulation of melanocyte within the dermis generally fade by 7 years of age. Head. A newborn's head appears disproportionately large because it is the 1/4 of the total length. When two or more sutures joining together, we call it a fontanel. There should be soft, fat and firm. Anterior fontanel will felt at a soft spot, diamond shape, 2.5 to 4 cm in length. Posterior fontanel is so small that it cannot be palpated, readily triangular in shape, 0.5 to 1 cm. Depressed anterior fontanel in dehydration, bulged anterior fontanel in case of elevated intracranial pressure, infections and hydrocephalus. Sutures. The skull bones are connected by fibrous joint called sutures. Suture lines never appear widely separated in newborns. Separation did not increase the intracranial pressure from the either from abnormal brain formation, abnormal accumulation of CSF in the cranium, or accumulation of blood in the form of birth injury. Few suture lines also abnormal and need to be confirmed with X-ray and further evaluation. Tadpole's eczema is a swelling or edema of the presenting portion of the scalp goes away in few days. Several hematoma is bleeding between the skull and periosteum of a newborn baby. Secondary to suture of the blood vessel crossing the periosteum, it does not process the suture line, disappears by weeks and months. Eyes. Newborns usually cry tearlessly because the lacrimal ducts are not fully mature until about 3 months of age. Eyes should be appear clear without any redness or purulent discharge. We should observe for subconjunctival hemorrhage, ophthalmic inertorum, presence of red reflexes, corneal reflex in response to touch, pupillary reflex in response to light, blink reflex in response to light, rudimentary fixation on object and ability to follow to midline. Ears, the level of top part of the external ear should be on the line drawn from the inner canthus of the outer to the outer canthus of the eye and back across the side of the head. Ear cartilage pinnae firm, cartilage felt along the ridge. Ear recoil, instant recoil indicate the baby's term. Startle reflex is by a sound, sudden noise. Mouth should be observed for cleft lip, cleft palate and tongue tie. Palpate newborn should be, the palate of newborn should be intact. Occasionally one or two small round glistening well circumscribed cysts that is known as Epstein-Barr's spin the palate. As a result, the extra lot of calcium that was deposited in utero. Sometimes in some newborns, one or two natal teeth may have erupted. Sucking reflex, rooting, gag and extrusion reflex can be elicited. Nose nasal patency and nasal discharge with white and thin white mucus. Neck short, thick, usually surrounded by skin folds. Tonic neck reflex can be elicited. Chest, it looks like small because infant head is large in proportion. Possible breast engorgement with possible secretion of thin watery fluid, popularly known as witch's milk, because of the endocrine effect of the mother's hormone. Absence of retraction. Anteroposterior and lateral diameters are almost equal. Slight sternal retractions present on inspiration. Siphoid process is evident. Respiration is mainly abdominal, cough reflex absent at birth and present by 1 to 2 days, bilateral equal bronchial breath sounds, rate and depth of respiration may be irregular, periodic breathing, crackles can be noted shortly after birth. Apex beat at 4th to 5th intercostal space lateral to the left sternal border, S2 slightly sharper, higher in pitch than S1. Sinus arrhythmia, heart rate increases with inspiration and decreases with expiration. Transient cyanosis on crying or straining. Abdomen, bowel sounds present within 1 hour after birth. Edge of the liver usually palpable 1 to 2 cm below the right costal margin. Edge of the spleen usually palpable 1 to 2 cm below the left costal margin by the end of first week. Abdomen is cylindrical in shape. Umbilical cord, it has two arteries and one vein. At birth, cord appears bluish white and moist. After clamping, it begins to dry and appears a dull yellowish brown and sheds after 6 to 10 days. Watson's jelly is usually thick around the umbilical cord. If the presence of one artery, then it is associated with water rat. That means V for vertebral, AF means anorectal, C cardiac, T transesophageal, and R means renal, and L is limbic abnormalities. Back. The spine of the newborn typically appears flat in the lumbar and sacral area. The base of the spine should be free from any pinpoint opening, dimpling or sinus tract in the skin, which should suggest a dermal sinus or spina bifida or occulta, lumbar head, tuft and hemangiomas. And anogenital area, the anus of a newborn must be inspected to be certain that it is present, patent and not covered with the membrane. Male genitalia scrotum is pendulous and both testes are present in the scrotum. Males with one or both antecedent testes crypto orchidism need further evaluation. Female genitalia. In female newborn, labia majora fully covers the labia minora. Some newborns have a mucous vaginal secretion which is sometimes blood tinged called pseudomenstruation. This disappears as soon as the infant system is cleared the hormones. Extremities as 10 fingers and 10 toes, full range of motion. Nail beds are pink with transient cyanosis immediately after birth. Decreases on angi to the of the sole. Simian creases, unusual curvature of the little finger and the simian crease, that means single palm crease, are the signs of Down syndrome. Sole is usually flat, symmetry of extremity, equal muscle tone bilaterally, especially resistance to opposing flexion, equal bilateral brachial and femoral pulses. We should observe syndactyly, that means fused verb digital, podactyly means extra digit. Mental reflex, also known as developmental primary or primitive reflexes, they can provide information about lower motor neurons and muscle tone. They are often protective and disappear as the higher level motor functions are emerged. Some of the newborn reflexes are blinking or corneal reflexes. Infant blinks at a sudden appearance of bright light at approach of an object towards cornea. It persists throughout life. Pupillary reflex, pupil constrict when the bright light shines towards it. It persists throughout life. Dorsal reflex, as the head moves slowly to right or left, eyes lag behind and do not immediately adjust to the new position of the head. Disappears as fixation develops. It persists to indicate neurological damage. Sneezing reflex, glabellar reflex, tapping briskly on the glabella causes eyes to close tightly. Sucking reflex, rooting reflex, disappears 3 to 4 months elicited by the examiner. Gag reflex, stimulation of posterior pharynx by food. Extrusion reflex, when the tongue is touched or depressed, infant responds by forcing towards yawn. Palmar grabs reflex, tonic nerve reflex of fencing posture, disappear by 7 months elicited by rotating the infant's head from midline to one side. Lower extremity responds similarly. Moro reflex onset is between 28-32 gestation. Well established in 37 weeks of gestation, disappearance by 6 months. The examiner holds the infant so that one hand supports the head and other supports the buttocks. Reflex elicited by sudden dropping of the head in the other hand. The response is serious movements. Infant's hands open and there is extension and abduction of upper extremities. Moro significance, absence or inadequate moro response on one side indicate hemiplegia, brachial plexus, palsier, fracture, clavicle. Stepping or dancing reflex disappeared by 3 to 4 months elicited by touching the top of infant's foot, the edge of table while infant is held upright. Babinski reflex disappear by 12 months elicited by stimulus upright the outer edge of the sole of the foot. Infant respond by plantar flexion, either flexion or extension of the toes. Crawling reflex, when the placed on abdomen, infant makes crawling movement with the arms and legs, disappear at about 6 weeks. Swallowing reflex persists throughout life. Then harlequin color change. Collagen is that the infant lies on the side, lower half of the body becomes pink or red, upper half is pale. This is entirely harmless and never been associated with any permanent problem. Then torticollis, where the head held to one side with the chin pointing the opposite side due to positioning in the womb, exercises the neck gently to opposite direction. Daily assessment of the newborn include head, antidepressant for bulging or depression, mouth for any infection, eye for any sign of infection, vital signs, respiratory rate is regular, smooth and quiet, temperature twice a day, umbilical cord any sign of infection, shedding of umbilical cord, feeding behavior, urine and stool passing, stool meconium passing urine at least 4 to 6 times a day indicate adequate feeding, bathe every third day, skin color for any jaundice, rooming in any abnormal behavior. Thank you for listening. If you have any doubts or any comments, please let me know.